Okay, so if I open Unreal Engine, the very first screen gives me over 15 different game templates for me to build from. Good. Cool. Very game engine-like, honestly. If I open up Unity, I'm given two starter asset templates that are lackluster at best, deliberately bad at worst. The FPS one doesn't even have shooting. So if you want to make a video game in the Unity video game engine, you're often redirected to the Unity asset store where you can buy other people's basic game templates. That way you can make video games without having to spend dozens of hours making common video game systems from scratch. And Unity gets a 30% cut of every sale from the starter asset marketplace, so they really don't have an incentive to make their own good starter assets when they're making a profit off of this current situation. However, here's the problem. Me. I am the problem. I want to make an open source non-gamer tutorial maker for game developers. The tool will help developers make tutorials that teach non-gamers how to play their specific game. If this was a normal project, I could pay the Unity overlords and lovely starter asset creators $500 for different character controllers for different game genres. But then I can't give my tutorial maker to any other game developers or make it open source, because someone could just take those character controllers without paying for them at the asset store. A solution would be to use Unity's current free starter assets, but these new first and third person templates almost seem intentionally worse than what Unity gave us before. So I want to make them better. I'm going to use this questionable base, my even more questionable programming skills, and the power of open source collaboration slash friendship to make Etra's starter assets. First thing I needed to do was mash together the Unity first and third person templates. The only major difference here is the camera. In a third person game, the offset camera has complex code that moves around walls so the camera doesn't clip into them even if you're in a tight space. For the first person character asset, we don't have to worry about walls, so the code is simpler. So I thought. I looked into the Unity FPS camera and the cameras were the same. For the FPS template, they just took the third person camera and they didn't even change the camera offset! The FPS guy's eyes are in his shoulder! Eyes do not belong there! So after removing the FPS player's eyes from their shoulder, I just rolled with the garbage and made a menu where you can swap between these two camera setups and character models. I made the main script manage gravity, movement forces, and gameplay type. Then I made a child object called the ability manager. Here is where I place the character's abilities to move, look around, jump, sprint, and hit rigid bodies all in separate scripts. Is this multi-script character controller efficient? I don't know. Probably not. I'm not too smart. But this is a system that other creators should be able to easily add to. And on the topic of making things easy for developers, my next step was to create a custom Unity editor window where developers can make their own custom characters without coding. Learning how to make these editor windows was fascinating. I had to make a custom set of functions that adds objects and scripts by name when the game isn't running, and as for the actual window creation, there are defaults, but Unity made an entire style sheet language, USS, to customize how the window looked. Of course, I had to use the USS language. No other language represents freedom from a capitalist marketplace like USS does. Here you can check what abilities you want to add to your character, what gameplay type you want it to be, and click create to add in your own custom character. So after that system was in place, I decided to add my own abilities. It was a bit of a struggle at times, but in the end, I added an ability to dash to both templates, an ability to crouch to the FPS template, and an ability to aim to the third person template. Eventually.
Whoa! There's nothing to do with the size! I see even taller now! Oh no!
And due to my naming system, all of these abilities were automatically added to the character creator when I made them. Before I sent this to the other creators, I wanted to at least add a gun to the first person shooter template and some things for you to shoot in the first person shooter template. So I made a gun, flashlight, and a sword, along with an item manager that allows you to smoothly switch between the usable FPS items. There are a few reasons these items are all FPS exclusive at the moment, but one reason is because all of them need to be rendered in a special way. On their own, these items will clip into walls if I walk too close to a wall. So what the FPS item manager does is it automatically adds a custom camera that only sees these items and then slaps that view on top of whatever reality actually is. Next, I worked with YouTuber Buffaloo to add his code-based bob and sway animations to each of the items. I also added a bit of screen shake to finally give these assets some life. Now that we had the blaster, I added some boxes to shoot at and a moving moving platform as interactable objects. That was everything I was going to add, so I tried posting it to the asset store, but according to Unity, starter assets need extensive documentation. So I kinda just copy-pasted Unity's own starter assets documentation, modified it a bit, and I made 25 minutes of video tutorials that you can find on my Extra Etra channel. I submitted the asset and... 20 to 30 days. Anyway, whether or not it was accepted on the asset store, that's irrelevant. What will make this asset actually successful is if other developers can add to it. So while waiting for approval, I sent a few creators and subscribers I knew an ominous link, and it was wonderful. One of my subscribers, Chris, quickly put together a treadmill, portal button, and chrismoment.html. I tossed those into the asset. Open source developer Asour went sicko mode and added a button interact system, a door and object grabbing system like from Portal. They then modeled and made a gravity gun. I even got game dev YouTube titan CodyCantEatThis to join in.
Hi, my name is Cody. You might have seen one of my videos before where I take an old 8-bit style game like Mario or Zelda and remake it in 3D using voxels. I've had people ask me how I animate these voxel models, so I thought it would be cool to include a script for that in Etra's starter asset. I made a few generic NPC looking models for the asset to demonstrate how it works. The script I made is called Model Swap, because that's exactly what it does. It iterates through an array of meshes when the character is in different states like walking or jumping. And that's pretty much everything for my part.
And with that, momentum has started. Now, I need your help. I want you all to add a ton of abilities to this free asset. Personally, I still have like 50 more abilities, items, or interactables that need to be coded in for my non-gamer tutorial tool. So any help towards getting that project done quicker would be great. But any feature you can think of, I would be happy to add to these starter assets. So join my Etra's Lab Discord below, and you can help there. If you can't do that, but still want to help me reach more developers, you can like and share this video as always, but the starter assets are also now on the asset store. So you can download them and leave them a review that says, "Wowza, these truly are some of the starter assets of all time." 5 stars. And that would be accurate because these truly are starter assets that exist. They are far from perfect, definitely not efficient, and not a replacement for the wonderful assets already on the asset store. If you're making a professional project, please support professional creators and use their professional assets. I just want these open source Etra starter assets to exist as an option, so it's never difficult to make small Unity projects and tools open source. I hope you can all help me reach that goal, and help me out with all the other non-gamer projects I have planned. Anyway, thanks to Chris, Asour, and Cody for collaborating with me, thanks to all my lovely new Patreon supporters listed here, and of course, thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye.